In this tutorial, we're going to cover how to use the DHT11, or DHT22, temperature and humidity sensors with the Raspberry Pi. The DHT11 and DHT22 are fundamentally the same from a wiring and software perspective. However, the DHT22 is a more accurate sensor. In this project, we'll be using the DHT11. If you have the DHT22, just follow along and everything will work the same. You'll just have more accurate readings. Both sensors will work up to 65 feet or 20 meters from the Raspberry Pi. This makes it ideal for remote mounting. I should also note that these sensors come as separate components or as modules. The difference is that the modules include a 10K ohm pull-up resistor on the board. If you decide to use the standalone sensor, we have a wiring diagram for that on thegeekpub.com. You don't need a breadboard for this project, but I feel like it makes things much simpler to understand. Especially if you're using one of these breakout cables. It makes the Raspberry Pi's pinout much easier to follow. There's a link to these in the description. Let's wire the DHT11 up to the Raspberry Pi. Connect the sensor's ground wire to the ground on the Pi. Connect the positive pin to the 5-volt terminal on the Pi. Connect the sensor's signal pin to physical pin 7, which is GPIO pin 4. If you wired everything up correctly, you'll see a red LED glowing on the DHT11 module. Next thing we need to do is install the DHT Python library. This is done by entering the command sudo pip3 install adafruit_DHT. If you get an error, see the link in the description for help resolving it. Okay, now let's take a look at the code we're going to use. This is some very basic code written in Python. This first bit of code imports the DHT library from Adafruit and the system time library. This line defines the sensor object we will use, and the next line is a variable that defines the GPIO pin we will be using. While true, just creates an infinite loop for the next bit of code. First, we capture the temperature and humidity to two aptly named variables, and then we check to see if it worked. If it worked, we print the temperature and humidity to the screen. If it failed, we let you know to check your cabling. Since the DHT11 and DHT22 can only be checked a maximum of once per second, we use the sleep function to pause 3 seconds between checks. To use this code, type in the following command, sudo nano mydht11.py, and paste it in from the link in the description into the window. Press Ctrl-O to save the file, and then Ctrl-X to exit. To run your code, enter Python 3 mydht11.py and press Enter. If you did everything correctly, you'll start seeing the temperature and humidity reported in the terminal window every 3 seconds. There are so many possible uses for these sensors. You can use them to capture the temperature of your Pi when it's in an enclosure in the hot summer heat, or you can use it to check the temperature of a room in your house when you're out of town. It's also very commonly used in creating DIY weather stations. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Do me a favor and tap that like button. If you find these videos helpful, maybe consider supporting my channel. See you in the next video.